My rheumatologist told me there's no cure for ankylosing spondylitis. You have to learn to live with your disease. After doing some research, I found a way to turn off my symptoms. I told my rheumatologist what helped me to turn off my symptoms. Could he share my happiness? Let's find out. I am an ankylosing spondylitis patient and turn off my symptoms. How did my rheumatologist react? I also know other patients turning off their ankylosing spondylitis symptoms. How did their rheumatologists react? My rheumatologist told me, I have ankylosing spondylitis. I should accept it and I shouldn't hope for a cure. But I still hoped. And eventually, I found a solution to turn off my ankylosing spondylitis. I told my rheumatologist. How did he react? Other patients who also turned off ankylosing spondylitis told their rheumatologists. How did they react? I'm lucky. Others helped me to turn off my ankylosing spondylitis. And with my videos, I want to help you. My rheumatologist told me, I have ankylosing spondylitis. I should accept it and I shouldn't hope for a cure. My rheumatologist told me devastating news. There is no cure for my disease, ankylosing spondylitis. I am no medical expert, only an ankylosing spondylitis patient. But for me, no cure sounded like I'm chronically ill and trying to become healthy again is hopeless. Pain, inflammation, and medication will be part of my whole remaining life. No cure sounds like my rheumatologist doesn't know how to cure ankylosing spondylitis. All other rheumatologists also don't know how to cure ankylosing spondylitis. All doctors worldwide don't know how to cure the disease. All humans worldwide don't know a cure for ankylosing spondylitis. And even in the future, there will be nobody who can cure AS, because a cure is impossible. My rheumatologist also didn't tell me about a possibility to live in a remission for years, without pain, without inflammation, and without medication. At this moment, I assumed being without pain, without inflammation, and without medication is being healthy. However, later I learned feeling healthy while officially still being sick is called remission. I am no expert, but permanent remission and healing feels similar to me. So my rheumatologist sounded like nobody knows how to turn off my symptoms. I started questioning that there is no cure for my disease. My rheumatologist told me there is no cure for ankylosing spondylitis. His statement implies there is no doctor and no medical paper which can turn off my symptoms forever or cure me. As a patient, I still had hopes. Could his statement be exaggerated? Does he know the entire medical literature? Does he know what all doctors know? Maybe somewhere out there is a solution for my problem. Maybe my rheumatologist just doesn't know. Maybe after work, my rheumatologist relaxes. He talks to his wife, plays with his kids, watches some movies, and is not up to date regarding the scientific literature. I continued thinking about the meaning of there's no cure. I noticed the statements of medical doctors are less strict than those of mathematicians. Mathematicians have solved problems which were solved already. Unsolvable problems for which it is proven that there is no solution. And unsolved problems for which nobody found a solution yet, but maybe in the future somebody can solve the problem. There are also math problems already solved by one person which are too difficult for another person. Once in a math test, I could not solve a math problem. However, other students managed to solve this problem. The math problem seemed unsolvable to me, but actually other people could solve it. Only because my rheumatologist knows no cure or permanent remission for ankylosing spondylitis, does it mean no human on earth can help me? Up to now, I didn't see any proof that becoming free of symptoms is impossible. After extended research, I found a method to switch off my ankylosing spondylitis symptoms. I am not healed, but I managed to turn off my symptoms as long as I practice no piso. And because ankylosing spondylitis symptoms are very uncomfortable, I keep my symptoms turned off permanently. One of the foundations of no piso is the research of a famous rheumatologist who worked as a professor at a university. He researched the link between ankylosing spondylitis, certain gut bacteria, and diet. He published his research describing those links, adding other research for modifying the intensity of inflammation. No piso is a method to implement those research findings into your daily life to get rid of your suffering. For me, no piso worked extremely well. I can live without pain, without inflammation, and without medication for many years already. I wanted to break the exciting news to my rheumatologist that I found a method to turn off my ankylosing spondylitis. Many see title as a foundation of truth, not if something actually works or not. Since I am only a patient without medical title, I worried that my rheumatologist will ignore my observation and my experience how to turn off ankylosing spondylitis. But I hoped he might be interested in the research findings of a famous rheumatologist, which was a professor. This rheumatology professor had a title plus found one of the foundations of no piso to turn off ankylosing spondylitis. I printed out the research from my rheumatologist and gave it to him during one of my last doctor visits. At this moment, my rheumatologist already observed that I had become better. I handed over the research and told him that this research from a famous rheumatology professor helped me to turn off my symptoms, turn off my pain and inflammation without medication. Unfortunately, my rheumatologist had little interest in this research. My rheumatologist is not the only rheumatologist disregarding this research. Other patients who turned off ankylosing spondylitis with the same or similar method tried to show their rheumatologist how to turn off their disease. Sadly, almost all rheumatologists react with disinterest, strong pushback, or at most tolerate no piso. There's little support or interest in no piso. The rheumatologist's answer: it probably doesn't work, but if it makes you happy, you can continue. There's no scientific proof that diet influences the symptoms of ankylosing spondylitis. Convincing my rheumatologist is not necessary for feeling better myself. I know no piso works because I tried it out myself. Doing no piso stops my symptoms. If I take a break of no piso, my symptoms fully come back within 2 weeks. It would be nice to convince my rheumatologist because then he could help many of his patients. But sadly, he wasn't interested. However, with my videos, I want to reach other ankylosing spondylitis patients. I hope many other patients can turn off their ankylosing spondylitis like me. Obviously, this is no medical advice, since I as a patient have no license or permission to do so. But I can show you the research and how I implemented the research findings into my life. It is your decision what you will do with this knowledge, because you are the master of your own health, not me and not your doctor. You are the master over your own health. I wish you can also turn off your symptoms, your pain, your inflammation, without relying on medication. I am lucky. Others helped me to turn off my ankylosing spondylitis. And with my videos, I want to help you. I don't dislike rheumatologists. I don't have a personal grudge. I think nämlich decent neighbors. But if there exists a method to turn off ankylosing spondylitis, and your rheumatologist gives you the impression that you can't change your suffering, this is bad in my opinion, because many people trust their doctor. And when they hear you can't change your suffering, then they live a life full of pain, inflammation and medication, and they suffer a lot. And their suffering is unnecessary, only because they don't know how to turn off their ankylosing spondylitis symptoms. I was lucky to have found a way to turn off ankylosing spondylitis and stop my suffering, but you still have many patients who suffer. So with my videos, I want to reach more people and show them how I become better, so my viewers can learn and hopefully also become better themselves. Do you want to learn how I discovered that Nopaisol turns off ankylosing spondylitis? Do you want to stop your suffering? Do you want to learn more about Nopaisol?